Okay, so let's take a look at our integration page. Jumping over to the documentation, we take a look at the fraud API, which is our end-to-end solution. It's the API of the Sense platform. What happens here is we can see the request, and we receive all of the relevant information ranging from action type, which is the various specified based on the various use case, ranging from login, registration, password change, any type of online authentication. Next, we receive all the information related to the online user and the online transaction, ranging from IP address all the way to user-related information down to transaction-related information. Now, we also have the last field, which is the user label field, where you can specify any industry-specific custom data fields. In case you're using your own device fingerprinting module, you can use the device ID field to feed us any device-related hash information. Now, if you're relying on our device fingerprinting module, then you should jump over to the JavaScript agent, which can be used in case of a browser-based fingerprinting. Alternatively, if you're using a mobile SDK, you can rely on our iOS or Android SDKs. Looking at the response of the API, you can see the various results ranging from IP analysis all the way to device fingerprinting and so on. We associate a state and a score to each and every transaction. The score goes from 0 to 100 and the state can be approve, review, or decline. You can set the various thresholds in the settings page of the system and you can play around with the configuration of the rules in the scoring engine.